Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. You know, a mitzvah which people are very much makbid on, and it's a great mitzvah, is the mitzvah of tzedakah. Institutions and people are mezaka yidin to fulfill the mitzvah of tzedakah. And there is a detail that perhaps should be discussed, especially when you have many, many pushkas sent to your home to donate to different great institutions, or Meshulachim send out pushkas and letters, pushkas in the shuls, and there is a question that has to be discussed, and that is, are you allowed to borrow some money? If you need money change for a bus or even a larger money, and you know that there is money in the pushka, could you take a loan from that pushka money, put in an IOU, etc., etc.? Is it already holy money because it was given to the pushka? And in a lower level, the question could be, am I even allowed to exchange, if I need some coins, to put a dollar bill in there, exchange it into quarters or dimes, etc.? Why is it even a question? Or what is the question? So in Yeridah and Hilchas Tzedakah, Simen Reish Nun Tes, Si'if Aleph, it says like this, Ha'imer Sela Zulat Tzedakah, somebody who says, he pledges, I'm giving this sela, let's say this $100 to tzedakah. Oi, sha'emer harei alai sela l'tzedakah. Or he commits to give. V'hi frishoi, and he's put aside the money. Says the Shulchan Aruch, at shaloi ba lidei hagabai, as long as the collector, the meshulach, the person, the fundraiser, before the fundraiser came and took the money, yochel l'shanoisoi, you could still exchange it. To take it alone for yourself, you could give it a loan to a friend, and you replace it with others. But that's only permitted until the gabbai tzedakah comes. But once the money, the pledge, went into the hands of the gabbai tzedakah is the hekdish, is the tzedakah. Once it's in tzedakah possession, you can't do any transactions with that money. So the question is very simple now. There is no person, if the money did not make it yet to the organization or the needy, the money is still at the pushka, which is pre-organization, pre-needy. Does that fall into the category that it came already into the hands of the gabbai tzedakah, uvechein? You can't use that money, or the tzedakah box is considered pre tzedakah, and at that pre gabbai, and at that point you could still exchange it, loan from it, etc., etc. That is the reason for the debate. When the Achrayim talk about this, they connect this to another halacha. There's a halacha in Choshen Mishpat. Choshen Mishpat, when it talks about the transactions, the kinyonim, when a sale is final, so we all know Meshicha, Hagbah, Kesef, that handshake, they make a deal final. In Shulchan Aruch, Simen Reish, Choshen Mishpat, Simen Reish, Si'if Gimel, it says like this, Kelav Shel Adam, if I have a vessel, a keli, a piece of an object. Now, if somebody wants to give something to me and consider the sale or the transaction final, obviously, when he gave it to me, it's for sure final. What's if I'm not around? I'm not available right now. So to put it in my home, it's also final, because as long as it comes into my rishus, it's mine. And once it's mine, the sale is done. How about he didn't necessarily put it into my rishus, he put it into something that I own. I have a keli somewhere, and that keli, the person B, Shimon, dropped it into that keli. Does that make the transaction final? And the Shulchan Aruch says, my objects, wherever they are, if it's a decent-sized object, as long as the object is allowed to be there, anybody who puts things in that object, the kinyan, the sale is done. The transaction is final. Kol makam sheyesh le rishus lanichoy konaloy. It's the acquisition, the kinyan is done. The Kivan shenichnezu ha-metaltelim b'toich ha-kli, once the metaltelim make it into the keli, you cannot change your mind. Aha. So the pushka is a keli for the needy. The pushka is a keli of the tzedakah, the yeshiva, or the meisa that it's representing. So if you put something in that keli, it should be considered done, over. It's bali de agaba, and you cannot take out the money. However, there is a clause. The clause is a chatzer, a keli, putting it into a keli, the kinyan becomes final only when it's a chatzer hamishtameres. Only if the keli is protected, is guarded. It's not open to the public. It's not just for everybody. If it's something that belongs to me, and it's protected, it's guarded, that's mine, so you don't have to bother to come to my house and put it in my hand, you can put it in my keli. If it's not mishtameres, if it's open to the public, then no. Putting it into the keli would not acquire or not make the sale final. How does that translate to the pushka? Most of the pushkas, at least in your home, are not locked and signed and sealed, closed. The pushkas are open. You could throw in another swara. Most of the organizations that send the pushka home are not really so much counting on the change that you're putting in that pushka. The pushka is really a reminder that there is this organization and they're hoping for you to give even bigger and better money. So it's not necessarily the sending the pushka, whatever form of a pushka, so that should be their representative and that should be their keli, and especially when it's not mishtamer, it's open. So if it's a pushka that's on the lock and key, then there is a svara to say that by putting it into that pushka, you shouldn't take any loan from that pushka. When, however, the pushka is open, and they don't even look at it as their chatzer, it's just as a reminder, most of the achrayim believe, in a case like that, you are allowed to, until the gabbai tzedakah comes, you are allowed to take, borrow some money, put in the IOU. Of course, you have to pay for it. Borrow some money from it, and before the gabbai tzedakah comes, you replace it and give other money. In a tzedakah boxes that are in a shul, and the tzedakah boxes are in the shul, not all of them under lock and key. Over there, there's a question. Some say that because they got the space in the shul for people, that's exactly how they want to make the money. The people dropping coins in there. So that space is their keli, is their chatzer. Even though it's not mishtameres in the way that we really want it to be, perhaps in the tzedakah box in the shul is more of a problem to borrow some money from that pushka for a long time.